the same attribute? Any answer? Why can't we say his knowledge is here and his sight is the same thing? Any answer to that? It saves the whole trouble now. If it's exactly the same thing, we just don't know what the difference is. Why not you say it's the same thing?
Is it
knowledge itself?
Because that's
what
knowledge is greater than human.
Is
that human knowledge is just a drop of?
No, what we're talking about, why can't we just say that his knowledge is here and his sight is the same thing?
Because we don't know.
It's not a rationalization that we can
make. Same thing. One, because we don't know. No, that's why we can't just automatically say they're the same thing. Second is, I mean, the key point is that he's mentioned three different things. So therefore, we say that there are three different qualities here. If we're going to say one, we've assumed something with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we have no delil for. And particularly, as you said, you can't rationalize this. It's based on scripture, it's based on Quran and Sunnah. When in the Quran it says he speaks, sorry, he sees and he hears, now we say they're two separate things because he said them differently. You want to now rationalize that they're the same thing because we don't know the difference between the two. So that's something you can't do. That's something you can't do because we don't understand the nature of these things, as the brother mentioned. Zahid, what were you going to say?
I was going to say because Allah SWT is three things.
Yeah, because you mentioned three separate things, we say, therefore, we can't come to the conclusion that they're one and the same thing. So we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears all matters, by which he's aware of all matters. What's the distinction? We don't know. It's a different one thing the ulama also say, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware through hearing, he's aware in a different manner. So the way that he's aware through sight in a different manner, through knowledge itself, through the attributes. Each one of them, we say that each one, he's aware of all matters, but in a different way he's aware, because they're different attributes, they're not the same thing. But what that difference is, again, now we suspend our judgment because we can't know these matters. Again, another example, we say, we come to a point in Aqeedah, we say, Allahu A'lam. We don't know the distinction between these matters. Textual proof was Sami' al-Basir. He's the all-hearing, the all-seeing. Sight, and that's, as we said before, we don't give rational proof for that. Sight is an existing eternal attribute that resides in his essence, by which he is aware of all existing matters in a manner different to knowledge and hearing. Was Sami' al-Basir. The same eye is the all-hearing, the all-seeing. There's an interesting point that the Mufassirin make here, the ulama of the Qur'an. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. There's nothing like him. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. He's the all-hearing, the all-seeing. Why does he say that after saying لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ? After saying there's nothing like him, he says he's all-hearing and all-seeing. Just in case you start negating the attributes of hearing and seeing. Because if you were to use the beginning point, you would negate the end point. If you were to look at the ayah where it says there's nothing like him, you say, therefore he can't hear and he can't see. So Allah subhanahu now confirms, yet he hears and he sees. Despite the fact there's nothing like him, he hears and he sees, but in a manner completely different to our hearing and our sight. What's the complete difference now? The mechanism, that's one. Secondly, he says he knows all matters. He knows all matters. These are eternal attributes. No, there's no beginning, no end. Every single thing that there is in existence is in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything, single thing in existence is in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any obscurity. Every single thing in existence is in the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here, likewise, the Ummah of Tawheed, the scholars of theology will make a point that human beings hear those things that can be heard, which are within the sphere of the human hearing. And there are certain things, many things human beings can't hear. Likewise, we only see, our sight is restricted as well. We can only see certain things. There are creation of Allah's fact that can see far beyond what we can see, like the Prophet. His sight was far beyond what a normal human being can see. He had panoramic vision, the Prophet. And he said in the hadith of straight in the rose, he said, فَإِنِّي أَرَاكُم مِّن وَرَاءِ ظَهْرِ. The hadith in Bukhari, he said, because I can see you from behind my back. The Prophet could see in front and he could see what was behind him equally, no difference whatsoever. He described the constellation Pleiades, the number of stars, which at that time couldn't be seen. There were stars that couldn't be seen by the naked human eye. He described those stars that were there, which have only now been seen. The Prophet had sight that no normal human beings have. But even that's not comparable to the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like human beings have different extension, the sight of human beings, there are different levels. Different creations, different animals have different sights as well. Different sights. And there's restrictions and there's differences to all of them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beyond all of that. And that's why, as we're going to read, the ulama of Tawheed will say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees all things that can be seen and all things that can be heard. He sees everything that exists, whether it can be seen or not, by the human eye. By the human eye. You can't see sound, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can. Why? Because He's aware of all things. It's not like through an eyeball that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not through an eyeball. It's by Him becoming aware, the mechanism we don't know. So there's now no restriction. Like, can you see a thought of a human being? No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can. Can you hear a thought of a human being? No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can. Can you hear and see ideas? Abstract concepts? No. They have an existence. Although it's in an abstract realm, they have an existence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees and hears all that. Why? Because He's aware of them. When we define that the mechanism being different, but He's aware of it. His sight and His hearing has no restrictions as human beings have. So we say it's completely different. Any questions on that? Because now we're going to go into a detailed discussion about the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is another important discussion now. Like the distinction between Kalamullah and the Qur'an. What is the Qur'an and what is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No questions on hearing and sight. So I'm not expecting anybody to come at the end to ask any questions, because everybody understands what's being said. Inshallah. The last of the